What's up, Acolyte Squad? My name is Prince, and I'm an urban acolyte. I'm going to share an unpopular opinion with y'all that some folks won't like, but Marvel needs to find a new person to play Black Panther. When I say a new Black Panther, I'm not talking about passing on the mantle. I'm talking about they need to find a replacement for Chadwick Boseman as King T'Challa. I know that's not what the mainstream is saying. That's not what you're probably hearing that the fans want. But I mean, honestly, I can give a damn about what the fans want, because usually when I hear about what the fans want, it's not something that I would care to see. And I know this is going to offend a couple of y'all, but sometimes what the fans want sounds really stupid. Let's talk real quick about what the fans want. The fans want Michael B. Jordan back as Killmonger to be the new Black Panther. What they want is for Doctor Strange to use the Time Stone to bring in Jadaka or Eric Killmonger back, but as a good guy this time, so that he can reclaim the throne in T'Challa's absence and be the new Black Panther. Okay, so first off, I mean, how does that make any sense? There's no Time Stone. Thanos destroyed it. Are we forgetting what happened in Endgame? Second, how does the story even make sense to accomplish all of this? I mean, if that's the case, you could just stick T'Challa, the character, in the multiverse of madness and have Killmonger replace T'Challa on Earth 616. The other thing no one thought about when they tossed out this idea of having Killmonger replace T'Challa as Black Panther is the story reason. Why is T'Challa no longer Black Panther? What, you're gonna have something happen to him off screen after he was already dusted in Infinity War? I mean, the character just came back to deal with a problem which some people think could be because of Namor and the Atlanteans. So let me guess, Black Panther 2 is about Namor versus Black Panther. Atlanteans versus Wakandans, and I know, let's have Namor kill T'Challa so that Shuri can assume the mantle. Shuri's gonna become Black Panther and avenge the death of her brother because, well, there's a couple of stories in the comic books where Shuri takes the mantle, and it's only natural she does it in the MCU, right? Except that it's not natural, and it doesn't make any sense. I don't know who needs to hear this, but Shuri becoming Black Panther is not what the fans want. Maybe you saw that on Twitter or in the Urban Acolyte Facebook group. You might have heard it on Charlie over on Emergency Awesome. Maybe that's what Charlie thinks will happen. But I'm going to say this with the utmost respect. When it comes to breaking down a story and reading into what's happening, look, I'm not really trying to hear what Charlie thinks. I mean no diss when I say that. I learned how to be a geek culture commentator from watching Charlie back when his channel was only Doctor Who and Avatar videos. But real talk, Shuri in the MCU is not on that Black Panther trajectory. Look at her in the first movie. She's the tech genius. It doesn't even look like she's had any training with the Dora Milaje. Killmonger smacked her down pretty quickly in the short exchange that they have in that movie. Now I realize that Killmonger got that perp in his system, giving him the Black Panther, Warrior, Abast, Super Soldier powers, but I think if Shuri were still on that level, she wouldn't beat Killmonger. That's just not who she is. Shuri ain't that dude. Not yet. Maybe not ever. And I don't want to hear this nonsense about how little black girls need to have Shuri become Black Panther. If you feel that Marvel needs to do something to please that demographic, well, I mean, first of all, you need to stop trying to spout this woke nonsense and actually pay attention to the damn story. Without the women of Wakanda, things would have ended pretty quickly for T'Challa. The movie is called Black Panther, and T'Challa is the main character. He's the dude in the suit. He's the guy on the throne. But the women were the true heroes. And I'm not even saying that to sound like some kind of male feminist. I'm just telling you what happened in the story. I mean, look who was in charge after the snap. It was Okoye. She was the one holding things down. Now, if you're one of the people feeling that Marvel needs to give us a powered sister, well, I mean, the X-Men are coming. What happened to all those people who wanted to see T'Challa and Storm get together and be the true power couple in the MCU? I mean, so what? Because Chad is gone, all of a sudden that's just not going to happen at all? And since I mentioned Storm, can we get a real black African woman to play her? No offense to Halle Berry, but hey man, we need a chocolate sister. Also, to all those woke people who are still demanding some black girl magic in the form of a superhero, hey man, Carol Danvers' play niece or her goddaughter, Monica Rambeau, yeah, that little girl, she's all grown up, and she appears to be working for S.H.I.E.L.D. in the WandaVision series. So if you didn't know, Monica Rambeau is the original female Captain Marvel from back when Carol Danvers was still going by the name Miss Marvel, and the original Captain Marvel died. So they had to find someone new to hold it down so the DC wouldn't take the name back. The MCU changed Carol's origin story by making Mar-Vell the scientist who was Carol's mentor on Project Pegasus. It also changed Monica's origin by making her Carol's goddaughter and the daughter of Carol's best friend Maria Rambeau, who flies by the handle Photon, which was one of Monica's aliases in the comic books. I'm saying this because we already have Monica Rambeau in the MCU. We're going to see her as an adult in the WandaVision series, and it only makes sense to me that she turns up again in Captain Marvel 2. Another woman of color inspired by Captain Marvel is Miss Marvel Kamala Khan, she's running for vice president with Joe Biden. Kamala Khan may also be introduced in Captain Marvel 2 before we see her in her own series on Disney Plus, or it could be the other way around, meaning her series comes first and then the cameo in Captain Marvel 2. So look, I just don't feel the need to make Shuri be Black Panther just to tick off some box for representation. Her character, based on what we've seen in the three movies we've seen her in, she's just not that alpha dog. I mean, until we get an actual Riri Williams as Ironheart, it would make more sense to have Shuri as some vibranium version of Iron Man, meaning she becomes the Riri Williams of the MCU. Some folks might not like it, but that's who her character is right now. And I mean, besides, weren't the fans saying that after Endgame? See, that's why you can't listen to the fans. The fans are never on the same page, and they don't know what people are working on behind closed doors. I mean, if Kevin Feige said that they were already outlining Phase 6 of the MCU, who would even have any idea of what those plans are? We have people right now who are ready to throw a fit if Wolverine doesn't show up in WandaVision, or the Falcon and the Winter Soldier series don't say that there's a dude named Logan who is part of the weapons program. It's the same thing with Star Wars. People who don't know the time think that the version of the story they want is what ought to happen. So look, I think the MCU needs to find a new actor to play Black Panther. I didn't say anything about replacing T'Challa. Ryan Coogler said he was writing part 2 with the intentions of Chadwick Boseman reading those lines. Chadwick Boseman, weeks before he passed, rest in peace, thought he was going to beat cancer and have time to bulk up again and play T'Challa in part 2. Also, you have at least three guys who doubled for Chadwick Boseman in the four movies where he appeared as Black Panther, and I don't think Chad would want to see those dudes out of work just because he's no longer around to play the part. I mean, Chadwick Boseman was supposed to portray the first black samurai, Yasuke. What are you going to do? You're going to get Letitia Wright to play that part too? I mean, look, the bottom line is that Shuri's character, she just ain't that dog, not right now. We saw her fight and she got dismissed fairly easily by Killmonger. There were already plans for T'Challa in Black Panther 2 and possibly beyond. I think we need to keep telling stories around that character, and if people really believe that T'Challa can't be replaced because audiences are going to compare the new guy to Chadwick Boseman, hey man, then let's find somebody completely new and give them a shot. Either way, I feel like there needs to be more stories around this character, and not having Shuri assume the mantle doesn't take anything away from her character or the audience, because unlike everyone else in the MCU, Black Panther is heavily dependent on the women around him. So I wanted to talk about people who I think would be great replacements for Chadwick Boseman as Black Panther or King T'Challa, but I think this video is long enough, so that'll have to be in a separate video. Hey, be sure to check back for when I get that video posted. But the next video that I have planned right now is probably going to be for the Marvel Avengers game, where I'll also be talking about Black Panther. As for this video, hey y'all, that's really all I have to say on this topic. So thanks for watching. Y'all keep on breathing, and I'll see you on the next video.